Hello, class. Welcome to week two. Hopefully you're understanding how the class is formatted and getting into kind of the groove of how this class will go. One of the first things I do want to do is remind you to get the worksheet for our class session. So if you go to our course page and then scroll down to where you found these videos, the class session videos, click on this link for the class session two worksheet. It'll pull it up and then just click this link right here to download the worksheet. Save it to your computer and then work on filling it out as you watch these videos. So to start off, I want to cover the learning objectives for this week. This week we only have three of them, so this is a lot maybe more manageable or won't feel quite as overwhelming as maybe week one did, where we were just laying a lot of kind of the groundwork for the course. So this week we're really focusing on the personal writing genre, or you maybe have heard it called the narrative genre, or like storytelling. So that's the goal of this week, and all of the assignments and readings are really connecting to that. But specifically, you'll learn about the writing genre in chapter 4 of our Bedford textbook. You're going to learn more about it by watching these class session videos and doing the worksheet, and then you'll have another exercise due on Thursday, and then you'll have one of our big essays due at the end of this week, the personal essay. So we're going to also kind of look back to week one and think about how did everything we learned about the whole writing process, how does that relate to writing the personal essay? So you'll get a little bit of a reminder of the writing process with chapter 18, and then you'll get to implement the writing process again by writing your personal essay. And then we're going to focus on a specific skill in writing that's very important to personal writing, and that is using descriptive detail and examples. And you'll learn more about that in chapter 22, and you'll get a chance to practice that in our Thursday exercise, the providing detail exercise. And then kind of your final culmination of that will be the personal essay. So I just want to remind you that the big essays are worth 10% of your course grade. Okay, so they're worth a whole lot more than the online class sessions or the reading responses or even the exercises. So even though these weights look bigger, when you break it down, they're smaller. So the exercises are really only worth 3% each because we have 10 of them over the course of the semester. But your personal essay is worth three times that. So really focus on this essay and doing well on it. And I'll cover more details about what this essay is later on in the week or later on in these videos. So what I want you to do now is we're going to continue to reflect back on week one. I want you to go and view the feedback I left you on your two assignments. So in the worksheet, there's a video to help you find that feedback. So if you go into this worksheet, and you probably noticed already in the worksheet, I want you to state the learning objectives for this week. You can either type them in word for word, which was on the slide, or put them in your own words. But the video that will help you find the feedback is right here. Just click on this link. If it doesn't work for some reason, send me an email and I'll send you the correct link. And then I want you to go to your paragraph exercise, find the code word I left in the document. This video right here will show you how to find that. And then just state, why did you get marked down, or where do you need to improve on your paragraphs? Because you will be using paragraphs for the personal essay. So it's good to know where to improve so that you can do that this week. And then also the reading response essay, I want you to view the feedback for that as well. I left a code word in the document, explain why you got marked down, and then what do you need to do to improve on this paper, and how can you improve for the personal essay example. Now, because you just turned in these assignments Sunday night, and you may be watching this video Monday morning, I may not have your grade yet for the reading response essay, so you may need to wait till about Wednesday of week two to be able to view that feedback. Although sometimes I do get assignments back to you on Monday. So if it's not available yet when you're watching this video, just remember to come back later in the week before submitting this worksheet to be able to answer these questions. And I do have a reminder at the bottom of this document. So if you have any questions, please get in touch with me. Go ahead and watch this video and complete this section of the worksheet before moving on to part two.